Welcome to Flow Sports and the 2020 Bad Boy Mowers Crossover Classic from the Sanford Pentagon in Sioux Falls, South Dakota. I'm Scott Coletti along with Jason Powers, and we have another good one in store here on day two, as it'll be a battle between the South Carolina Gamecocks from the SEC taking on the Gonzaga Bulldogs out of the West Coast Conference. South Carolina, the number one ranked team in the country in the early going this year after finishing number one in the 2019-2020 season cut short due to COVID-19. The Gamecocks 32-1 a year ago, a perfect 16-0 in the SEC. Currently 2-0 after a resounding 119-38 win over Charleston on Wednesday and an 81-71 victory yesterday against South Dakota. Gonzaga finished 28-3 overall a year ago, 17-1 in the West Coast Conference. Marks the first time for Gonzaga that the program finished, and the second time in the last three seasons they faced a top team in the nation. The last time Gonzaga faced off against the number one team in the nation was November 22, 2018, when it took on Notre Dame as part of the Vancouver Showcase, November 22, 2018. And for the second time in program history, the Bulldogs are ranked in the preseason Associated Press preseason poll as they debuted at number 21. And I'll tell you what, Jason, when you look at Gonzaga, the one thing that they have, and South Dakota had some good size, this team has a lot of good size.
Absolutely. When you have the Worth twins, Jen and Leanne Worth, both coming at 6'3", you have a little bit of size coming off the bench as well. You got a 6'5 player, and you got another couple of 6'2 players. So I think this will be a very good matchup versus the inside strength of South Carolina with Aaliyah Boston, Leticia Amaher, and company. So I think it will be a good battle on the interior tonight with the Worth twins matching up with the strength and power of South Carolina.
Yeah, and Jill Townsend for Gonzaga, collecting a lot of national accolades as she became the first Zag in program history to be named to the preseason National Award watch list. As you look at South Carolina, last year 32-1, Dawn Staley, 13th season, and what a coach she is.
She's done a great job at South Carolina. She's brought that South Carolina program to a perennial top five program in the country. Again, they're number one ranked. They've been ranked multiple weeks in the AP poll. I think it's 11 straight AP polls they've been ranked number one, and they've just got a powerhouse program that she's building in Columbia.
58-52 in favor of South Carolina over Gonzaga, Bad Boy Mowers Crossover Classic.
Well, Scott, if you're Coach Fortier and they told you you'd be down 6 points against the number one team in the country in your first game, you could take it down six with the ball.
They get another opportunity after the missed three. Shot clock down to 7. They feed it inside, and a nice layup with the left hand by Melody Kempton.
Great job by Kempton sealing off the low post there for the easy layup.
Kempton now with 6 points, 58-54.
If you're South Carolina here, you've dominated the game in the paint. Excuse me, Scott. You've dominated the game in the paint. You're 36-24 in the paint. Keep pounding it in the paint. You're killing them on the second chance points. You're up 14 second chance points. Keep pounding it to Boston, to Amaher, and then utilize Cook and Henderson to finish off from the...
Impromptu timeout taken as we had a shaken up Gonzaga player.
They may be looking, Scott, at the replay. There might have been an elbow thrown by the South Carolina player onto the Gonzaga defender. They may be looking if that's potentially a technical foul for a flagrant foul of swinging the elbows.
Yeah, it was Beal. Made a move right there.
Yeah. You saw her bring her elbows with the ball across her body and clip the Gonzaga defender right in the jaw. That might be a flagrant, a a flagrant foul.
So they did call a foul on Beal. They didn't say whether or not it was a flagrant foul, but they said it was a foul on Beal.
In both the men's and the women's game, they're really trying to keep those players with the ball from swinging those elbows with those tips of those elbows out and creating that contact in the face area. So good call there by the Fnatic on review.
9:02 to play in regulation time, a four-point lead for South Carolina. Turnover, and it goes out of bounds to South Carolina.
Scott, what do you think the effects are of Gonzaga not having a crowd in the building really to help their momentum and help their adrenaline to keep up? They're playing great right now, but a full house here rooting for Gonzaga would be such a difference in this atmosphere.
No, that's a great point, Jason. And, Gonzaga, I think if they had a crowd, they'd be getting rowdy as well, as the foul was on Gonzaga.
Because, you know, as sports fans, we always want to see the number one team in the country kind of go down, especially when you're on a neutral court like this in a tournament setting. So I think it was, if we did have a crowd, everybody would kind of be on the Gonzaga side, kind of like yesterday. South Dakota played pretty well for three quarters, but just no crowd to help them get over the top might have played a factor.
Pass inside, and that is up and good. Victoria Saxton with a layup. 60-54, back to a six-point game.
Yeah, great look there by Cook.
And that's going to be a travel. Liam Worth called for the walk. 60-54, yet another turnover. As that is the 15th turnover for Gonzaga.
Definitely been a big factor in this game. The live ball turnovers that have led to transition points for South Carolina are key here, especially with the dynamic guard play that South Carolina has.
Saxton, turnaround try off the mark. They fight for the loose ball.
Gonzaga's had some success in this game shooting the three-point shot. They've made six threes. They're shooting 40% from the three-point line. So if you Townsend a good look, if you can get Leanne Worth a good look, I think you got an opportunity to begin to cut into this lead. Again, you're only down two possessions here with 8 minutes to go.
60-54 in favor of South Carolina. Shot from the outside is good for three. Hitting that jumper is Kaylee Trong. Oh, check that. That was Jem Worth from Trong.
Nice job on the defensive end there by the Zags.
Whistle, and we're going to have a timeout here. 7:12 to go in the fourth quarter on Flow Sports. A four-point lead for South Carolina from the Bad Boy Mowers Crossover Classic in Sioux Falls, South Dakota. Scott Galletti along with Jason Powers, and Gonzaga continues to fight down by four with the ball.
Great job by the Lady Zags with Coach Fortier. Staying in the game, shooting the perimeter three, and there you have another three. You got a one-point game.
Yeah, how about that? A nice three ball from the outside. And that was clutch. Kaylee Trong with another triple.
They are shooting the lights out in the second half. Yeah, shooting the lights out in the second half from the three-point line. And now Gonzaga has the ball.
And that's the one difference that South Dakota had yesterday. They missed a lot of three balls where Gonzaga's hitting them. The Zags 7 of 16 here today. Chance to take the lead. And they try for a three and got it from the outside. How about that? As that was Jill Townsend with the triple. 62-60 Gonzaga and a foul down low as they got the ball to Boston, they being South Carolina. But how about the Zags just hitting the three?
They are shooting the lights out here in the second half of the three-point line. That's at least their fifth or sixth three-point shot in the second half alone.
Yeah, they're 8 of 17 in the ball game, all totals, 47%. And that's going to be an offensive foul called against South Carolina as they got Destiny Henderson.
If you're Coach Staley here, you're a little concerned because your team is not playing very well on the defensive end. They're a little sloppy in the offensive end. This is danger time for South Carolina.
Their only loss a year ago was to a ranked Indiana team. As last year, South Carolina went 32-1. The Zags only lost three games, 28-3.
The big stat in this game, Scott, Gonzaga shooting nearly 60% from the field in this game, over 59%. They've made 8 of 17 threes. I mean, that's to me, that's the difference in the game is the offensive efficiency of Gonzaga so far.
Townsend and Worth playing the back and forth game. Worth missed the runner. And Boston with the rebound. Here comes South Carolina quickly the other way. That's going to be a layup miss, but a foul, and they'll get two shots out of this. And, you know, it's really amazing how fast the South Carolina team is speed-wise, as Destiny Henderson just brought it quickly down the lane, and two players couldn't stop her, and you could see why, because once she got the afterburners going, there's no stopping her.
No, she's not afraid to be in the lane with the big players to try to draw the contact and try to lay it in. So good job there by Henderson, taking the ball hard to the rack.
5 of 8 shooting, 2 of 3 at the line, make it 3 of 4 now. Henderson with 14 to tie the game. Got outside, miss. Worth got the rebound underneath. Scoop it underhand, and what a shot by Jen Worth.
Great job there with the rebound, first of all, then the body control, and going to the left hand with the little scoop and score.
You saw that spin move by Henderson, a miss by Emma here, and it goes out of bounds to South Carolina. But that shot by Worth was outstanding.
Man. Beautiful. This Gonzaga team is for real. They are highly ranked. They got a bunch of veteran players. They can play with anybody in the country, as they're showing here today.
Cook missed, and the foul's going to stay down here. Gonzaga getting a foul. The Gonzaga players, Townsend didn't like it, number 32.
Coach Fortier has taken this Gonzaga program to the NCAA tournament 4 times under her reign. They would have gone a 5th time last year had the season not been altered because of COVID. So this is a championship-level program that she's putting together.
Jen Worth, you saw her leave the game. She has 4 fouls. Cook fell down and a turnover. Here nice come defense. The Zags up by 2. Shot is missed and a rebound. Here comes South Carolina. Guess what? They're running. And they're tying the game and a chance to take the lead. How's that? As Destiny Henderson, we just talked about her speed, Jason.
Oh, yeah, she's the road runner up and down the court. Her and Cook are both electric in the open court. Remember that sequence. Townsend missed a pretty easy layup at one end, and it turns into a three-point play on the other end, a potential five-point swing here, 5 minutes to go in this fourth quarter.
And timeout called. We have a good one. It is tied at 64 on Flow Sports. Tie ball game here in Duke Ball, South Dakota, the Bad Boy Mowers Crossover Classic. And we've had a great game, Jason Powers, Scott Galletti along with Jason Powers. And trying to give the lead to South Carolina is Destiny Henderson.
Again, we're going to see in this last 5 minutes of the ball game, veteran experience versus the youngsters from South Carolina, which one of these people teams can handle the heat here in the last 5 minutes in a great game.
1 point game here. Gonzaga trying to work it around. Scanlon. Shot clock down to 7. They get it to Kempton. Kempton puts it up and in. What a shot by Kempton.
One thing I've Gonzaga big man mastered that little up and under scoop off the glass. They are very good with their feet. Very good positionally, being able to get in position to lay those little scoop shots up off the glass.
And that's going to be a foul on Gonzaga.
And here's another question
Kempton
for you, Scott.
Kempton with 8 points.
Yeah, another question for you. South Carolina's not used to being in any of these kind of tight games. Most of their games, they're comfortably ahead. So it'll be interesting to see how South Carolina responds here this last 4 minutes, especially from the foul line.
Yeah, they had a couple of close games a year ago, but not very many. So this is uncharted waters as Henderson missed the first and misses both of them. And rebound Gonzaga. Sierra Walker has been very good from the outside. Townsend. Gonzaga patient. Down to 10 on the shot clock. Kempton outside. They kick it in the lane.
Good
a
luck.
Little shot in the lane is off the mark, and the rebound, South Carolina.
If you're Coach Fortier, you'll take that look. That's a good look late in the shot clock. Just missed about a 7-8 footer.
Another foul, and South Carolina will have an opportunity here to take the lead. But Gonzaga, the 21st team in the country, leading number one South Carolina by one. See changes coming in. Kempton goes out. Lily Scanlon goes out.
Yeah, you're going to go with your best. You're going to go with your best starting five here this last 3.5 minutes for both teams. You're going to get the offense, the Worth twins back in the game. Townsend. Great minutes there by Scanlon and Kempton to get him to the 3 minute mark here, right in the game, tie ball game.
Henderson makes them both. It's a 1 point South Carolina lead. Now we'll see what the Zags do. They've been very solid, haven't rushed anything. Very impressive effort by Gonzaga considering it's their first game.
Absolutely.
Kaylee Truong, she can hit it. She'll fire for three, and that's a foul.
Boston with Boston. Aaliyah Boston tried to block the shot and got her with the body. That's a good call by the official.
Yeah, I had to wait there a second, Jason, because I thought she got all ball, and then the whistle happened. The ball went out of bounds, and she's going to get three foul shots.
It's a cardinal sin there by the post player. You do not want to foul jump shooters, especially late in the shot clock, shooting a three like that, bailing out Trung, sending her to the line for three.
She missed the first. Whoa. Missed the second. So now the best she can do is tie the game. This is where you wonder on the other end, Jason, how the pressure is affecting the Gonzaga players.
Yep. Because they probably didn't think they were going to be in a one-point game with the number one team in the country either with under 3 minutes to go. So there's pressure on both sides. Absolutely.
And she missed all three. It remains a one-point South Carolina lead, and they have the ball with 2:56 to go in the fourth quarter.
Gonzaga shooting 28% from the foul line in this game at 2-for-7. Remember that number.
Yeah. Yeah, they were just 2-for-4 a second ago. The ball goes inside. It's on the ground. Boston fighting for it. Got it. couldn't get the shot up to go, but she got the shot off, and she'll get a pair of foul shots. That's the toughness of Aaliyah Boston.
Absolutely. That's just physical toughness. Good job digging that ball off the ground. Good job by the Gonzaga defenders. And a good strong take to the rack by going to the line for two.
And that's the fifth foul on Jen Worth. So she has to leave the ball game. So that is a big loss for Gonzaga. Jen Worth leading the way with 16 points on 7 of 9 shooting, 2 of 4 at the line, but is fouled out, and Boston hits the free throw. Two-point game. So somebody's going to have to step up for the production that Jen Worth is leading with.
And I think if you're Gonzaga, you really got to, try to find a way to get her loose on a screen, either on the baseline or up on the perimeter, to try to get her a good look.
Three-point.
Maybe even Leanne Worth on as a perimeter jump shooter here in the waning moments.
Ooh. Good call. Yeah, she stepped on the baseline. Yeah, you saw that right there. Kaylee Trong bounced the ball on the baseline, and it's a big turnover, another one. And that is number 15 for Gonzaga, 12 for South Carolina. You see the overhead shot right there of the turnover.
Absolutely.
Very
absolutely
clear.
Yeah, and Trong was the one who just went to the line and missed the three free throws. So she's feeling the heat, the pressure of the moment a little bit here as the sophomore point guard.
Three in the corner. And that's going to be off the mark, but good rebound by Beal, and she scores. Bree Beal. She can do that
kind
off
of
the glass, and Beal with 12.
I'm really surprised 48 didn't take a timeout right there. This is a Christian to score.
Shot by Leanne Worth is off the mark. Good rebound, Boston. South Carolina now, minute 37. Trying to close things out against Gonzaga. And a shot up and good. And count the bucket. Good bucket there by Zaya Cook. So when it isn't Henderson, Zaya Cook always brings it to the basket.
Absolutely. Strong take there by Cook. Drew the contact. She's going to her right hand, her dominant hand. A great finish there to now create a seven-point separation. Make it eight.
So Gonzaga scoreless in the last 2 minutes, 47 seconds. And that's not the kind of trend that you want when you're trying to upset the number one team in the country, but they're down 8 all of a sudden.
Yeah,
that's after they had a chance to go up by 2 with 3 free throws.
Yep, and the 3 free throw misses at the line, and then Trong with the lazy turnover on the baseline really was a big swing in this game here in the last couple of minutes.
So a minute 33 to go in the third. If South Carolina holds on, there will be a presentation after the game with a trophy for South Carolina going 2-0. Tomorrow we'll have Gonzaga in South Dakota. That should be outstanding. There's the backcourt pressure by South Carolina. They get the ball in the front court, does Gonzaga. And the layup is missed. Tough shot by Kempton, as it was a good look. And it is going to stay on this end, a foul against South Carolina.
Again, Kempton's not used to having to handle balls like that low to the ground, but a good job by Kempton, but you got to make that. That's a layup you got to make here down 8. We'll go to the line for some free throws, though.
Yeah, Sierra Walker with an opportunity here at the line. Each team with 5 team fouls. See the timeouts, each team with 3.
Yeah, I was surprised 48 didn't take a timeout a couple possessions ago because you had plenty of timeouts when you were down five to get a good shot. But no timeout leads to the three-point play on the other end. Now you're down eight. The positive thing here, if you're Gonzaga, is that you don't mind fouling if you make the, if you can make these free throws. You don't mind fouling because South Carolina is not a very good foul shooting team. So you're Staley. You need to get the ball in your shooter's hands. Henderson, Beal, and Cook. So they do go to the line with some of your better foul shooters.
9-0 run by South Carolina over the last 3 minutes. A 12-2 run over the last 4 minutes.
And again, you have a championship-level team here in South Carolina. They're used to playing with a little more pressure than maybe Gonzaga is, so these moments aren't quite as stressful as you might could be than they might be for the Gonzaga ladies.
Sierra Walker missed the second one, dives for a loose ball, gets it underneath, and missing the layup was Kempton. And another foul is going to be called. This time it's going to go against Gonzaga, I think.
Yes, against Gonzaga. Yet a great look underneath by Kempton. Could have cut the lead to five, and she missed a little footer right there under the back. And then it turns into a foul the other way, shooting free throws for South Carolina and Aaliyah Boston.
Yeah, Aaliyah Boston with 10 points on 3 of 5 shooting, a perfect 4 of 4 at the foul line. Couldn't get that one. One more coming, though. South Carolina, 20 of 33 at the line. And 20 of 34, the rebound taken by Jill Townsend. Minute 7 to play. Gonzaga has to hurry to get some points. Although they're playing patiently right now. Townsend outside, near side. Three ball by Walker is good. Sierra Walker makes it a 4-point game.
Great
Man, she's
job
a
there
solid
on the,
shooter.
Oh, she really is. She's the transfer. Again, Walker is the transfer from Vanderbilt. Came over here, and she's done a great job. That's her 4th three-pointer of the day. She's 4 or 5 from deep, and a huge 13-pointer here for the Zags. You're still in the game here, 54 seconds.
Now, what do you do here, Jason? Do you foul right away and send them to the line? Or do you try
I do.
To go
I
for
probably
a
give myself. No, I probably give myself 5 or 6 seconds to potentially trap and steal. But if you don't have that initial trap and steal, then I think you definitely send South Carolina to the line and make them make free throws. They're shooting under 60% for the game. They didn't shoot very well yesterday from the foul line. Make South Carolina shoot free throws to win the game.
Lisa Fortier, her team, have been very solid today. Their first game of the year, South Carolina playing their third. This would have been a 4-team tournament, and you would have had Oklahoma in it, but because of COVID-19, after their opening loss at home against Houston, they were unable to come to South Dakota. So you had a 3-team tournament, if you will. South Carolina getting early tests. When you schedule these kind of games, you want to test anyway, but this has been a nail-biter for Dawn Staley's team.
And I think it's good for the Gamecocks. It's easy to play games when you win by 20 or 30 and you're comfortable. I think this is a great test for Dawn Staley and the Gamecocks. And I think deep down, Staley's probably happy that the games are this close, because they want us to, she wants to see team react, especially early in the year, to a stressful situation. And this has been very stressful throughout this entire third and fourth quarter.
Destiny Henderson was fouled quickly. Scanlon with her third personal foul. And Henderson, 6 of 9 at the line. 7 of 10 now.
That puts her at
75-70.
Great job. Yeah, great job, Henderson. She scored 19 yesterday, another 21 today. A big offensive force for the Gamecocks early in the 2020-21 year.
Now a two-possession game if you go for threes for Gonzaga. They can shoot the three, but they're not just a wheel deal three-point shooting team. Townsend out top, 40 seconds. And there's a near steal. It's knocked out of bounds, or is it a foul? It's going to be a foul, I think, on Amihir.
That's the last thing you want to do. The last thing you want to do if you're Amihir in the defense is foul. Again, 40 feet from the basket, you know, and to stop, and more importantly, to stop the clock. Play good defense. Don't foul. Make them burn time off the clock. Even if they were to get a two-pointer there, make them use more time on the clock.
So now they have a chance to get two points with the game clock stopped. 34.7 on the game clock. Free throw up and good by Leanne Worth. Her sister Jen Worth fouled out of the game. Jen Worth left the game with 16 points. Free throw was missed and a foul called, and Amy here will go to line,
timeout,
or did they
South
just
Carolina. No, timeout.
They just called
timeout. South
timeout.
Carolina.
Okay.
South Carolina timeout.
So Gonzaga was trying to foul, but she got the timeout first. And the key here, I believe, is that they can move the inbounds pass into the front court, much like an NBA rule. They changed that a couple of years ago when they went to quarters. They changed the rule where you can get the ball inbounded at midcourt like they do in the NBA, as opposed to going the full length of the court.
That's a good rule change. I like that rule change. You want to encourage the offense to try to... Good shot.
76-71 in favor of South Carolina. South Carolina does inbound the ball in the front court, and they hurry and they foul, so we're going to have free throws coming for the Gamecocks. 75-71, and Leticia Amihir will go to the line once again. Amihir has had an outstanding tournament. And Amihir will go to the line only with 5 points today. 2 of 5 shooting. And she's now 2 of 4 at the foul line. So that is a big foul shot for Emma here. 6-point game, trying to make it a 7. And couldn't do, but a big rebound by Boston. And now they have to foul quickly, and they do, and that will send Lili Grissett to the line. But man, what a big rebound by Aaliyah Boston. That was absolutely huge, Jason. Six-point lead for South Carolina. And the ball's on the ground, and another extra possession. That's 3 times in a row as Zaya Cook got it. And they will go back to the foul line with Henderson. Henderson hits the free throw. One more coming for Henderson. It's an 8-point lead for the Gamecocks of South Carolina with 21.9 on the game clock. And timeout is called. 79-71 in favor of South Carolina over Gonzaga. Gonzaga has had a lot of opportunities. Their top scorer, Jen Worth, went out of the ball game with 16 points after fouling out. Kempton also fouled out for Gonzaga. Two players with four fouls, Townsend and Leanne Worth. And Boston for South Carolina with four fouls. Other than that, South Carolina has completely stayed out of foul trouble. But South Carolina trying to go undefeated, trying to go 2-0 here at the Bad Boy Mowers Crossover Classic, and trying to go to 3-0 on the young season. If you look at Lisa Fortier, her team has done well in the first game of the season, but you almost have to play a perfect game against the South Carolina team. Liam Worth with 14 seconds, three ball on the left wing, that's off the mark. Will remain Gonzaga ball with 10.6.
Nice job by South Carolina finishing out this game in a tight situation. Good for both teams.
Finished on a 15-1 run, to be exact, Jason.
Right.
Gonzaga was actually looking to go up by two.
Yeah, we had two big moments in the fourth quarter. We had a missed layup by Townsend that turned into a three-point play on the other end, which is a five-point swing. And then we had Trung at the line miss three free throws on the three-point attempt foul. Those were the two big moments in this game that really hurt Gonzaga in this fourth quarter.
And next one is good. So a 16-1 run by South Carolina. And that will do it. The ball game is over. The final score, number one, South Carolina, 79. And number 21, Gonzaga, 72. We'll come back and have some post-game comments in just a moment on Flow Sports. Welcome back here to the Bad Boy Mowers Crossover Classic in Sioux Falls, South Dakota. You see Aaliyah Boston with a trophy as one of the top players. They're giving trophies out to the individual players and also the main trophy as South Carolina will finish at 2-0. Zaya Cook, along with Aaliyah Boston, getting an all-tournament trophy. Zaya Cook today, 16 points. Destiny Henderson also will be all-tournament. 23 points for her, Jason, and what a tournament she had. 6 of 11 from the field, 10 of 13 at the foul line.
Absolutely. She had 23 today. She had 19 yesterday. And this is a player that last year, she was kind of the leader of the second unit. So her role has completely changed this year from being a kind of a sixth man off the bench to being a impact scorer in the backcourt with Zaya Cook. So what a job by Destiny Henderson. Taking her game up to another level heading into the 2020 season.
Jill Townsend and Melanie Kempton tried to keep Gonzaga in the ball game, but too much South Carolina. Victoria Saxton got inside. Kaylee Trong with a three ball, but then Henderson started going to work as she took the ball to the basket time after time along with Zaya Cook.
And again, I think as if you're Coach you Staley, see, you're very glad that you got tested in both of these games. Both of these games were not decided until late in the game. So I think Coach Staley, long trip out from Columbia out here to South Dakota, I think they're very happy that they got pushed in both games.
Gonzaga shot well from three-point range. Some of the misses coming late going, but 9 of 19, just 2 of 5 for South Carolina. But I say just because they proved they could hit them yesterday, but today, when push came to shove, they took the ball right down the middle. As you see, Aaliyah Boston with the championship trophy, or one of the trophies, I should say, as you know, what an effort by this team. They are 3-0, 2-0 here at the Crossover Classic. And obviously, the number one team in the nation, they're going to be tough to beat.
Absolutely. Coach Staley's got a great program in Columbia. They're going to be the odds-on favorites in the SEC this year, and they're going to be, they'll be one of the two or three, four teams that the experts and broadcasters will all think will win the national championship this year because they've got championship talent, they've got a championship coach, and they've dog named champion. Coach Staley's dog at home, her name is Champ. So, and go to, she's even got a social media page, Scott, of all things, Coach Dog. On social media, called Champ.
Very nice. Well, tomorrow we have a good one in store. Gonzaga will be back in action against South Dakota. That will be 3 p.m. Eastern time, 2 p.m. Central, 1 o'clock Mountain, noon Pacific time. So join us right here on Flow Sports. And, Jason, it's been a lot of fun. One more game tomorrow.
Absolutely. I think it's going to get a good – tomorrow will be a very competitive matchup with two teams that are very, very highly rated on the west coast of the country. So I think it'll be a perfect test for both teams with their second game of the year. And wanted to say hope everybody had a great Thanksgiving weekend, and we'll see you tomorrow at 3 o'clock.